This video goes with section 83 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek, an intensive course, and covers third declension adjectives. Hansen and Quinn covers this material on pages 263 to 264. Third declension adjectives are pretty much what they sound like. Unlike the adjectives you've learned so far, which modify their nouns in case, number, and gender using endings of the first and second declension, third declension adjectives use endings of the third declension, which are here in front of you. You're going to learn two kinds in this chapter. The first are of the type eudaimon, eudaimon, and there you can see that these are two ending adjectives. That is to say, one of the forms, in this case eudaimon, is masculine and feminine, and the other one, eudaimon, is for everything neuter. You're used to that sort of arrangement with first and second declension adjectives very often when the adjective is a compound word. Here with eudaimon, eudaimon, you can't this time use really the rule subtract os from the genitive to get the endings because you're not presented with the genitive singular in your vocabulary entry. So really, you have to learn these patterns so that you know what the stem is. In the case of eudaimon, eudaimon, and you've got several other adjectives of that type even in this chapter, in the masculine and feminine, the nominative appears in the vocabulary, eudaimon, and the genitive singular is eudaimonos, which means that our stem is eudaimon, which you can see arrayed here in all of the cases in both singular and plural. And so our endings then get added very nicely, just as you would expect. Eudaimon, eudaimonos, eudaimoni, eudaimona, eudaimones, eudaimonon, eudaimon, oh, there we are, with the damn dative plural, which is going to try to be this form, but that's not really possible. And so the nu drops out, and you get the form eudaimosi. And then eudaimonos and eudaimones. I believe I forgot to pronounce the vocative singular, eudaimon. Accent is persistent and is given on third declension adjectives by the neuter nominative singular. And you can see here that that wants the accent to be an acute on the upsilon of the first syllable there. And so that's where it's going to try to be on all of the forms in the masculine and the feminine. And so here's where they go. As you can see, it's only the vocative singular where it manages to be that far back. Now in the neuter, the nominative singular, of course, is eudaimon. And that's the stem for all of the rest. And we can put in the endings quite like this. So in the singular, we get eudaimon, eudaimonos, eudaimoni, and then the accusative and vocative are the same as the nominative in the singular, as is always true for the neuter. In the plural, eudaimona, eudaimonon, and then we get the dative plural. And again, not quite pronounceable this way, the nu drops out, and we get eudaimosi, and then eudaimona and eudaimona. You can hear me already doing the persistent accent, again, based on the nominative singular of the neuter. And so it goes in like this. Now, those are fairly easy, not a whole lot to trouble you once you know how to form the genitive singular and what your stem is. Our next kind of third declension adjective is the type eugenes, eugenes. And we're going to do it first in the masculine and feminine. And here, of course, is the masculine and feminine nominative singular. Now, the genitive singular is eugenus. And you may recognize what's happened there because you've learned nouns of the type genos, genus, where you see that there's a hidden stem that ends in epsilon sigma. Well, that's what's happening here. The intervocalic sigma drops out, the epsilon and the omicron contract with one another to give you the u diphthong and the ending us. And so if we put that S stem all the way through, first we're going to have it here in the dative and accusative singular, and then in the vocative singular, I'm going to go ahead and put the final sigma on it because the vocative singular of the masculine feminine is simply going to be the stem. And I'll put the medial sigma on the rest of those stems so we can see what happens. Then let's try to put the third declension endings on all of these masculine and feminine adjectives. So it's going to try to be this form in the dative singular, but the sigma drops out and you get the ending A. Accusative singular wants to be that or used to be that. The intervocalic sigma dropped out and it contracts into the vowel A. In the nominative plural, instead of elgeneses, the intervocalic sigma goes away and we get the contraction elgenes. Similarly, in the genitive plural, no intervocalic sigma, the epsilon and omega contract, and we get elgenon. The dative plural here simply loses the extra sigma. The accusative plural goes by analogy with the nominative for the masculine and feminine and has that same S ending, which also contracts. And it's the same as the nominative plural, and the same thing happens, of course, in the vocative plural. Accent is persistent and is given by the nominative singular of the neuter. And so as you can see here, it wants to be entirely on the S of the stem. And that's how you can see it's almost always going to be in all of these contractions on the last syllable, except in the dative plural, where the S is the second to last syllable. In the neuter, now we know it's elgenes, elgenus. And I've put in all the stems, including the accusative and vocative singular that are simply going to be the same as the nominative because we're neuter now. And I'm going to show you one more time how all those forms come to be. So the sigma drops out and we get elgene. In the nominative plural, the sigma drops out, the epsilon and the alpha contract, and we get elgene. The sigma drops out in the genitive plural, the epsilon and the omega contract, elgenon. The extra sigma drops out, elgenesi. And then the accusative and vocative plural are just like the nominative plural. Again, persistent accent. And here's how it looks in the final forms. So that's the two varieties of third declension adjectives that you need to know now. Remember that adjectives always agree with their nouns in case, number, and gender, and that they can be used substantively.